हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डू द रिवीजन ऑफ द पोएम अ टाइगर इन द जू। आई होप यू रिमेंबर, वी हैव डन इट अर्लियर एज वेल एंड देन आई एक्सप्लेन्ड द पोएम टू यू एंड गेव यू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एंड सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस आल्सो आई टोल्ड यू, बट बिकॉज यू नो योर ड्यूटीज आर कमिंग सो आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज द पोएम फॉर यू वंस अगेन। In this poem, it is given that there is a tiger. When this poem is written by a poetess, and the name of the poetess is Leslie Norris. So, before I explain the poem to you, I would like to explain its summary. Actually, this poem contrasts a tiger when it is in its natural habitat and when it is imprisoned in a zoo. On a starry night, the poetess sees a tiger in zoo. The tiger moves slowly up and down in his cage. He is full of anger, he is full of rage, but is quiet because of his helplessness. The poetess is moved to see the tiger there. She says that the tiger should have been in jungle and he should have been quietly being in the shadow near some water hole and waiting for a plump deer to pass that way. But sadly, he is locked behind bars in a concrete cell. He takes no notice of the visitors and is looking at the brilliant stars with his brilliant eyes. Why doesn't he look at the visitors? Because he is bored. This has been the daily routine. Now he has to be counted with merely looking at the stars. He is no longer free to move in his natural habitat and look at the brilliant stars from there. This is the summary of the poem that the poetess wishes to tell you about the poet. And the poet is set at two places. The first place is the natural habitat. The first place is in the zoo. Then, during the poem, the poetess takes us to the forest, to the jungle, the natural habitat of the tiger. Then, as the poem progresses, we come back to the zoo. So, let's read the poem. He stalks in its vivid stripes. The few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. It means the tiger is in the zoo. He stalks in his vivid stripes. Vivid stripes means this is the physical feature of the tiger, that he has stripes on his body. The few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet, because you know his feet are velvety. And in his quiet rage, it means he is in anger. And the few steps of his cage, it means he moves here and there in the poem. So what does the poetess want to say? That the tiger is having the vivid strips on his body, and his feet are velvety, are soft, and he walks with his soft feet in the cage. He moves only few steps and then comes back, and he is in anger. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the water hole where the plump deer pass. The poetess says that he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass. It means if he is not in the zoo, then where he should have been? Then he should have been in the forest and lurking there in the shadows, sliding through the long grass. For what? Near the water hole where plump deer pass. He should have been waiting there. He should have been lurking there in the shadow where the water body is there, where the pond is there, so that he can wait for the deer to come, so that he can make the deer his food. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Now, if he was in the jungle, then he must be snarling around houses. Which houses? The houses which are at the jungle's edge. If the tiger was in the jungle, then he should be terrifying the people who live in the houses at the jungle's edge. Baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. It means he must be snarling. He must be roaring and terrorizing the people, terrifying the people, where the people will be terrified. They will get afraid by seeing the, by hearing his voice or seeing him in the village. But he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. You saw in the first stanza, the tiger is in the cage. In the second and third stanza, he is in the forest, in the jungle. Then in the fourth paragraph, again, but he is locked in a concrete cell. It means again, we have come to the zoo where he is locked. He is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars. The poetess says that the tiger is not free to roam about, to terrify the people and to wait for the deer. He is locked in a concrete cell. He is in a cage, his strength behind bars. And because he is kept in the cage, so his strength is of no use. His strength is behind the bars of the cage, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. You know, so many people come to see the tiger there in the zoo. So he ignores visitors. He does not look after them. He does not look at them. Actually, he is bored to see them time and again because it has become the daily routine. So he does not care for them. He just ignores them and walks, stalking the length of his cage. It means he walks slowly. How much? To the length of